them, you will find your out-of-pocket expense component going up. It will start going up. When it goes up, now it's about 45-50, there's a dispute between government and IHP figures and government figures. The moment it goes over 60-70, there will be social turbulence. There will be social turbulence. I mean, every country has gone through that, we will also have that. So we need to be careful. Now, Thailand, what they do is, whether it's private sector, public sector, the Thai Health Authority, that's an independent body, but ultimately under the Ministry of Health, like on other things, they have prescribed, they use a medical system. New Zealand also, they say, okay, for this type of surgery, we give you 1,300 pound. Whether it's government sector or private sector, they give the same. So if you can do it cheaper than that, that profit, extra profit is yours. Of course, it needs good management, good management. If you are going into a private sector model in our developing country, you have to work it out on that basis, a little bit more detailed analysis. Now, of course, if we do open the gates now, I suspect, you say Savanthi's hospital, the current one. All of Sri Lanka, 10% people have insurance. We tried in say about 10 years ago, we did a study with insurance companies to promote more insurance for health insurance. Health insurance at that time, they lost in all the all the insurance companies lost on health insurance. They offered health insurance as a shop to get life insurance. Now a few companies are doing it. Now 10% health insurance can never prevent people going bankrupt. And what do our health insurance the companies do? I know this game because I studied this very carefully. What do they do? They say, okay, maximum insurance is up to 200,000 for a year. Then they also put a clause, to get that 200,000 you have to be warded in a night. If you get warded only, you get that money in some places. So I had my son-in-law who had a problem with his shoulder. He couldn't get the blast and go home. The bank doesn't pay, he took it home, it cost him 90,000 rupees something. But he had to stay a night. Then only he gets insurance. So our things, we need to study this in much more detail. There are no easy solutions to this. We can conceptualize and say if this works, this is. But our work we do is not enough. We'll have a utterly confused system if we just say, right now, what private sector we are trying partnership here right now with them, and the spillover goes, or the shortfall goes, and that's it. Each one's going to be in another partnership. Yes, sir.
I know that the health ministry is seriously thinking of a partnership, but I see a problem because we are short of specialists. Now, it is true that there may be 600,000 cataracts to be done. That is what the policy told us. So what he planning to do is say 100,000 Rasri or 100,000 or whatever. So it has to be some doctors who are working in the government sector who have to go and operate during the spare capacity, which is morning time. And then we will have problems. Then there will be nobody to work in the government and they will be doing the partnership work. So I think we have to look at all these things before we actually, at least the government must pay.
As Professor said, we are currently working on, but it's such a complicated issue as he mentioned. But we've like worked on it for a couple of months now and making some progress. And the other thing is, I think from private sector, I think they are apprehensive if you give a subsidized rate to the public sector. What is preventing from people who are actually capable of paying standard fee now, going back to state sector and getting it reimbursed. That will totally upset the current system. So there are a lot of aspects to look at. And more than that, ask for a price. There should be standardization of hospitals. The cost of every hospital is not the same. So you can't ask for one fee for a particular procedure when the facilities, the infrastructure is not the same. Unless there is standardization and minimum quality standards and a grading and external evaluation, you can't process it. You put the basics in place first.
Can I comment on that? Which is the KDUP is doing a global study, I suppose. So that is why we should change it to, because they are going to use state of the art healthcare models to predict before they treat the patient. It's a good thing.
Contribute to what Dr. Samant said, like in collaboration with the public hospital, and like we are going to have a very good radiology services and cardiac services, so to relieve some of the burden from the of the public hospital, we can contribute at a lower price. We can, with the facilities and the team, we can always compete with the rest of the public hospitals in order to do that, and that will benefit us also.
Good will and on aspiration.